Ladies and gentlemen, today is September 29th, 2015, and this is the Kane Kale Show, episode 262, where we learn to be better artists. I'm your host, Keenan Lafferty, and today we are going to be jumping into the visual update for none other, because you guys got us to our next goal on Patreon, Night Raven Fiora, and we're going to be talking about the process that went into designing the skin, and yeah, we're going to be having a good time with that. Looking through PSDs, looking through JPEGs and all that stuff. Before we get into that, we need to take a stroll down a very special place, and that is, of course, not the Patreon, we are already there, the lovely Lane, because you guys have been submitting your amazing works to the Facebook, and we need to make sure we scroll properly. There we go. All right, for those of you who want to go see these for yourself, just type in that tiny URL. Super simple. Back by the Facebook blue. Couldn't get it any easier. Go check them out all for yourself. Like the page, submit your work, get featured on the show, and come get some cookies. All right, ladies and gentlemen, with all that out of the way, let's go ahead and get into the reason why you showed up. I know why you're here. It's for the Night Raven Fiora visual update, okay? And we're going to start things off with a story, okay? Starting things off with a story. So I was really excited to get this assignment from Riot because I remember back when Fiora actually released, right? This was probably, I don't know, like 3 years ago, back when I was working in-house for Riot Games. And the release was going just fine. My coworker Owen Colgan was actually the designer for the base of Fiora. And I remember looking at his artwork, it's just so beautiful, it's so amazing. Definitely just type in like old Fiora concept art, you can see some of his work there. And then back then, for those of you who've been playing League for quite a while, you will have remembered that when we released new champions, they always came out with not one, but two skins. They came out with two skins. And of course we had the obligatory, like, okay, well, she's like a fencer, so hey, let's make a musketeer. Hey, that's easy, right? And that one turned out pretty good. And then, but we were struggling with what her other skin would be. What's the third skin gonna be? And so we came up with Night Raven Fiora. And I think it was meant to be like some sort of like ninja assassin thing. I didn't really understand what it was, but it just kind of looked like a dark Fiora. But looking back on it now, I feel like it was more in tune for like a Noxus Fiora, because she's with Demacia, and this is like kind of like her darker self. So anyway, I was tasked with the visual update to this, and I was super excited because I was like, okay, cool, now's my chance. Now's my chance to make this skin a little bit more interesting, right? Because before I just wasn't really, I don't really like Fiora that much on my own. I don't like to play human characters that much. I always like the monsters, right? But I love to design clothing, and I especially love drawing the sexy ladies. So of course, I was super excited for this assignment. So let's go ahead and get into it, right? Let's go ahead and get into it. And I'll be making a couple notes here, and then we're just gonna kinda tick on through this PSD, and then I got a couple like, got a couple progress shots for you. So you guys might be asking me, well, Keenan, if you were given such an assignment, how do you even get started? How do you even get started on that? Well, the first thing that I would do is, of course, I go onto LOLWiki or LOLKing and grab a screenshot of the actual model. And then I'll begin actually just sketching out the body, right? And I've taught you guys how to do this many, many times. So if this is your first time seeing this strategy or this technique, then you haven't been around here for a while. But that's okay, because I'm gonna refresh your memory. So I compose the body in terms of very simple shapes, right? A good old hourglass, you know, kind of kick those legs off of there. And remember that S shape. You guys know about those S shapes. I taught you all about them. Getting that little curvature in there. If I were to exaggerate it, it would look like that. See, it's a backwards S. One like that. Getting a little bit of that flow in there, right? Get a little bit of that flow. Sculpt that body into place. And then we can begin drawing the clothes on top. I know some of you think that this is a naughty technique, right? But it actually works. It works really good, especially for skin-type body suits. I almost said scoots. Body scoots. But anyway, so of course, I was super excited because I've been playing a lot of Bloodborne lately, right? For those of you who know, there is a character in there by the name of Eileen the Crow. And she has, as soon as I heard Night Raven, I thought immediately of Eileen, right? And so I was like, oh, okay, cool. So I really like, she has like this big old feathery cape and this like leather jacket. And I was thinking of turning this more into sort of maybe like a Victorian, almost like a Bloodborne-y type of skin. Something that would resonate a little bit more with Night Raven. But here's the question that's always in the back of my mind, or here's the thing that's always in the back of my mind. And that is, how can I introduce a new flavor to this without losing what people may have enjoyed about the original skin, right? What the few people out there may have actually enjoyed about this original skin. Don't want to go too far away from it, right? Not too far away. So let's go ahead and move into progress shot one. So this is what I really like to do with all of my concepts whenever I send them off to Riot, is I really like to explore. I'll explore a bunch of different ideas, a bunch of sketches, and those can be seen like here and here and like to here, right? This is, I take everything to kind of like this point. You can even see I was doing something back here where I was changing up like the pants, I think. Was it, making a little bit more skin tight type of pants thing. And then let me go ahead and take or get rid of these here, see if there's something else. Let me just go ahead and put a couple more of these layers up, see if there's anything we missed. But yeah, I'm basically exploring a few different types of styles. See, here's another one where I'm saying, okay, well maybe this one has like a metallic chest piece. Let's see if we can kind of work that in and do a different kind of style, maybe like an armored style, right? And then now we can move to this. Because the most important thing that I do when I send this off is I want to have three sort of moods. I want to have moods for this skin. That way the people over at Riot, my good buddies, can choose which style they're liking. And three different ways that have been refined to, you know, not like super like refined, but you get the idea, right? This one is sort of like Underworld. This one here is more like a Noxus style with like the plate armor. And then this one is very much like Eileen the Crow from Bloodborne. So I give them these three different styles, three different directions. And then they can kind of pick and choose and tell me which one they like, what they don't like, you know, a couple different things. And all the while, I'm always thinking to myself, okay, what is one thing? Another thing that I really like to do is I like to ask myself, what is one thing about the original skin that didn't quite translate over? And for those of you who have actually looked at this model like very closely, you'll see that there's actually feathers in the pauldron as well as kind of coming out like her backside here, not like out of her little hip guard or whatever. And I was like, oh, that's really cool. I like the feather motif, but that wasn't really executed to the point where you can't even see it in the game. So I really wanted to think of a way that we could bring some feathers into it. So moving on to the next thing. So my buddies, I actually report to Marino, who you guys know as Iron Stylus. He got back to me, he gave me the feedback saying, okay, we really like the armored style of B, right? Want to see some different things on that, want to see some different variations on that. So, and right about this time, I was like, okay, all right, so I'll start doing some variations, small variations on these plate designs. All right, you can see it's just like very, very small changes in like value. This one has like little, maybe it'd be better if I just draw on top of this. This one has like little like cape things or like cloth mixed into it. I like to vary up my materials as well. Like it's like, okay, well here's plate, but we also have cloth happening here. So maybe we should put some cloth here as well, you know? So thinking about things like that. And then variations. And the feathers, of course, don't forget the feathers. Don't you dare forget about those feathers, because I really like the feathers and I wanted to bring that in. Whether we did it through the cape or under the pauldrons, just wanted to make sure that it was much more it had a lot more readability than it did before. And then, hey, we're getting right into our good old fencing thing. What are these things called? Fencing. For some reason, I can't think of it. But anyway, our fencing weapons, our lance. That's not a lance. Okay, whatever. But this one, for those of you who play Bloodborne, look at that. That has a eerie resemblance to the Reiter Palash. I really liked that design in that game. And I just like the shapes, right? So oftentimes people will pull up, like I'll always pull up a bunch of different types of like weapons, right? And I'll kind of pull like shapes, right? Shapes and flows like this, right? So see, there's like one, two, three, like that type of thing. And then you got the blade and just like cool little relationships. I'm looking for cool little relationships, not directly copying, but heavily influenced by, because it's always easy to, you know, vary it up once you've got, you know, something that you like. I think this was the first one that I drew, and then see, like over here, I took that and I made number two. I was like, okay, well, I like this shape here, you know, but let's kind of vary it up. Maybe we can put like a spike there, and then this blade here, let's go ahead and maybe have like a design like that, you know? So just kind of coming up with different designs, right? And for those of you who know about my design rule, you might be able to see a lot of it happening here. Remember that large, medium, small thing that I taught you guys about? Medium, small, large, not lard, large. But if you look closely at all these designs, you can see that there are mixtures of that design rule being put into play. Okay? So moving on, let's go and move on to the next one. So eventually what we ended up doing was I took a pauldron and I decided to completely change it up, like a really, really massive pauldron, and then getting those feathers like coming out of there, because I thought that was one of the coolest iconic things of the previous skin that didn't really come to light. Nobody didn't see the light of day. So I needed to fix that, right? And then the design for the weapon that they ended up going with was this one right over here. I think it was previously named B, but they liked just the way that the blade kind of came together right here. And it looks really cool when I turned it kind of to the side and rendered it in a 3D space. Right? It looked really cool. Like, I love the spikes and just looks really elegant, but also kind of mysterious and dark. So that was really cool. And we just ended up kind of simplifying the pants. Before, it had like these big old cloth things hanging off. Just took that completely out, just kept the pants there. But I kept them, and there was like a plate that came down her thigh, got rid of that, and just turned it into a design on her leg. So a lot of just kind of simplifying, right? And the reason why I get a lot of this feedback to simplify is because you gotta think, it's like, yeah, this concept looks really nice here, but what's gonna happen when you take that and then you shrink it down to the size of, you know, like this, right? Well, as soon as it renders, there we go. What happens when you shrink it down to this size and you're viewing it from in the game? You know, how is this actually going to read? Is it going to be really noisy? Oftentimes, if you have too much detail in your drawings, it is going to be noisy. So you got to make sure that you keep in mind like where your materials are separating and just the overall shapes that you're going to be seeing from the in-game model in the game. And I'm always like comparing it to this one over here on the left. Always comparing, saying, okay, is there just about as much detail here as there here? You know, if the answer is yes, then I know that I'm on the right track. Because, hey, somebody already did all the work before. They already figured out how to collapse all these shapes and make it all, you know, nice and good looking for the game. So I just kind of follow that. So I was really liking it at this point. I was really, really digging this, really happy with that big old shoulder. And then eventually, I think we ended up switching it. Oh yeah, here's an example. Speaking of feedback, here's an example that I will get back. When I get feedback, it usually looks like this. And this was given to me by my coworker, Jem Lim, who is an amazing artist, the designer for the new Tristana visual update, right? So basically anything that she tells me to do, I'm just like, yes, yes, Jem. I can't believe I didn't think of that. You are so genius, you're so brilliant. Just tell me what to do and I will do it, right? So anyway, here's all our feedback. Just kind of things for the cape, kind of changing up silhouettes. Again, it's all about silhouettes. We need to kind of break these things up. Let me choose a different color because she used red. She already used my color, or maybe I was using her color, I don't know. But anyway, like breaking up the silhouette and you know, like collapsing the cape so it tapers, as opposed to, it's before it was kind of like this type of thing. She wanted it to be like that, right? Or that's exactly what you drew there. So, oh, and also breaking up the silhouette on the sword, right? Kind of making this bigger and making the tip of the sword kind of come out and just kind of giving it a little bit more of an interesting shape. All right. And of course, we got our good old back view. And I forget the way that I did this. Oh, I know what I did. Usually what I do is I will draw my back views. Sometimes they have a model that I can reference, but if not, then I just kind of do the same thing. All right, I'll just draw, you know, my body in there, draw the body in there, and then build everything off of that. But the back view can always be much less detailed. It doesn't have to be as detailed as this one here. Like, see how nicely all the metals and everything are rendered out. The back view doesn't have to be that nice, and this is like a badly compressed JPEG. Let's move on to the next one. Hey, this one's much better. Okay, so a problem that I foresaw was that I think that, in her new visual update, she has two pauldrons, right? And the larger one is actually on her left shoulder, right? But currently, the way that I had it set up was that her pauldron was on her right shoulder. So we needed to, of course, switch that over to the other side and have her holding her weapon with the right hand. I can't believe I still can't think of what the name of this thing is. Her righter palash, I'll just call it that. Her righter palash in the right hand. And just like little things here. And then the most important thing, bringing this all over, bringing it together, doing your in-game angles. They want to know, how is this actually going to look once it's placed in-game? specifically having to do with, you know, does this blend in? You know, you might imagine a problem that we had when we were creating Zach was that he was green and that everything behind him was green. So we needed to make sure that his hue or just his value in general was enough to kind of pop him off the background, or at least, basically pop him off the background. So that's kind of what I'm looking at here. I'm always looking at, okay, how are these colors going to work with the background of Summoner's Rift? 2.0, how is that going to work? You know, so you do it from this angle and you do it from the back. And these are always really fun because it's actually quite challenging. And these are actually drawn right over top of the model. Oftentimes I actually just take the model itself. And I think this was drawn right over the old one. But so it's pretty simple. Pretty dang simple. And here's another shot of that back. Now, the final thing that we ended up doing was that they wanted me to also do like a front. Like, they wanted me to render out the back one. Usually I don't do it this way. I think it was just a special case in the, for this one, because we were kind of under some time constraints and they wanted everything to be perfect, right? Everything needed to be perfect. So, of course, I rendered out the back as well as did a straight-on front shot. So that way it was much easier for the modelers to get in there and actually know exactly what the texture should look like. So that really helped out a lot. And that was pretty fun. And this is an example of when I will actually paint over the model. Let me see if I can actually find that here. It should be right here. Yeah, here we go. So let me show you what the model actually looks like behind this that they send me. Looks like that. Cool, huh? Pretty dang simple. There are some weird like things in front of it. What is that? I don't understand what happened. Okay, there we go. So yeah, here's a good example of the model that they send me. And then on top of that, see, this is the base model. And then on top of that, I will just build the skin on top of it. So it's very simple, very easy. And I like it when they send me these models because it makes it so much easier. It takes all the guesswork out. I can make sure that her legs aren't like super long or like too short, you know, and just all the proportions and stuff are taken care of. So that leaves us with our good old, and this was basically the final piece. So all of that progression, all that stuff. And for those of you who are curious about how long this stuff usually takes, I think this one took about maybe 2 to 3 weeks, right? On and off. I had some other things that I was working on as well. I don't know if I can talk about that. Actually, I think I was working on Gangplank at the same time, right? And Gangplank's up next because you guys are awesome and you got us to the next goal. And I'm really sorry. I've actually been feeling a little bit under the weather. I think after the con, my immune system's already like fighting an uphill battle, but then I had like a really crazy cookie last night. I don't know like where this was made, but they said it's made fresh. It was from the pizza factory down the street. Ate this cookie, and immediately after, I felt like my throat like closing up and like starting to get all congested. So I don't know what was in that cookie, but it definitely did not help. So that's why my voice is totally going bye-bye. But anyway, okay, so let us, yeah, I think that's gonna be it. I think that's it. Yeah, I just feel like there's something else I need to do. And it is sponsors. I'm not going to forget my sponsors today. In fact, let's just go ahead and get those out of the way. My sponsors, come to me. Thank you, Defenders of the Cane Kale Kingdom, David Cariello and Laura Machine. These people are awesome. They are my sponsors on Patreon. And I got a new one. So I need to get to work on creating his animated portrait. But if you would like to check out ways that you can support the show and get cool stuff like that, just click that little link. Oh, and speaking of, it says download the PSD. A lot of you might be wondering if you want to check out this PSD or if you're going to be able to see this PSD. And the one that I'm going to be uploading specifically is probably going to be this one with all the sketches. There's a ton of like little sketches in here, just how I went about like getting started on this thing. So I'll probably just be uploading this one for you guys. And you guys can go ahead and download that one and enjoy it for yourselves. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, with all that out of the way, we're going to call it good. We're going to end this show. People on YouTube, thumbs up if you like it, thumbs down if you don't. My name is Ken Lafferty. You guys take care of yourselves. I'll see you on Thursday, where we will be doing something I'm not sure about yet. But I'll see you then. And until that time comes, you guys take care. See ya.